Hey, brothers and sisters, this is your favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are doing all right. The Lord keeps giving me a lot of great messages, brothers and sisters, and just don't have time to make the videos. But by the grace of God, you know I always say that. I want to get on here and make them. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I've been waiting to hear back from a few people about locking in the exact location and the time to meet this coming Saturday in the greater Charlotte, North Carolina area. Just waiting on the feedback, but it will be Saturday afternoon somewhere in the greater Charlotte area. I'll be back with details later on, at a later date this week. Anyway, so praise God. I have many people we're going to meet together there. Praise God. We'll be praying for words of wisdom, words of knowledge, making plans for a fellowship there. So praise God. There are several people who are interested in having a weekly fellowship. So praise God. By the grace of God, when I'm here, I'll be able to go down there and be involved with it. In the weeks I'm not there, well, they can go forward with it. So this coming week. Next week, I'll be meeting people in, I'm trying to think of where's the exact location where we would meet. In the High Point and Asheboro area of North Carolina. That'll be the next Saturday, July the 18th. And then after that, the next week, Chicago. I will be in Chicago 22nd, 23rd, 24th, and the morning of the 25th in the greater Chicago area. I'll be in Naperville. And I'll be there. You can email me if you're in the Chicago area, you want to meet me. I'll be baptizing people there. I'm going to be staying at a place that's got a pool. We can baptize there in Naperville, Illinois, a suburb of Chicago. And we have lots of people, but I believe, you know, as far as baptism and all that and praying with people, I'll stay up as long as it takes and see all the people. And by the grace of God, I always try to do with that. You know, in the Philippines, I prayed for the count that I have. Maybe it was more other times. We saw 1,000 people in a medical mission / evangelism / prayer for healing. 1,000 people in 3 days. And I prayed with every single person to receive the Lord. And I laid hands on, prayed for every single person for healing and all that, because it was a medical mission also. So praise God. As the Lord would give me the zeal of His Spirit to do it. Then in Minneapolis, the 25th, 26th, and 27th, White Bear Lake, Minnesota, just a suburb of close to Minneapolis, Minnesota, brothers and sisters. So praise God. Praise His holy name. Bless His holy name. So anyway, and this coming up week in Charlotte, those of you guys who will be there, you know, Brother Sid, who I talk about, who's been doing the website for us, I ask you guys to pray about that too. Our website, Church of the Firstborn, we've been having all these, they've been trying to ask more. The website host, ipage.com, they kept asking us for more and more money all the time to keep spamware off of our website, and it became a scam about spam. So, brothers and sisters, I'm not a big fan of spam anyway, unless I don't have anything else to eat. So, brothers and sisters, we decided to go ahead and let them, they kept threatening they would shut us down. So the Church of the Firstborn website is down because they keep shaking us down for more money. So I ask you guys to pray about that. We're praying. Brother Sid has gotten moved to the greater Charlotte area. So I'll be seeing him, of course, this coming weekend also. And with a group of people, and by the grace of God, we'll start a fellowship there. But anyway, I asked if there's any computer programmers, anybody that would like to help us out to rebuild the website on a different host than iPage, like WordPress or whatever, like the joshuasministry.com website is WordPress, and the patrickwinfrey.com website. The brother in Australia set that up for me, and he's busy. He works, and he's in Australia. I pray that God would give us someone in the U.S. that we could talk to on the phone. Brother Sid and the person could work together and myself, and let's get the website built, because I want to start having live events. We've been talking about it, and it was hard for me to do from the Philippines, but now that I'm here, we can do tiny chat or whatever, live events. Q&A. I'm thinking about doing Q&A stuff where people could call in and ask any kind of question about the rapture, the end times, faith for healing, baptism, Holy Spirit, anything, and we could have it live, brothers and sisters, so it can just flow with it. And that's what I'm believing the Lord wants us to do. Anyway, if any of you guys will be able to make it down there, you'll be surprised. Get to meet Brother Sid. You know, Brother Sid is a man of many talents, and I was just thinking of, you know, that a lot of people will be surprised of all the things that Brother Sid has done in his life. Get to meet somebody he usually doesn't tell people, but you know, Brother Sid was a I can't say it with a straight face. I was going to say that Brother Sid used to play guitar, a backup guitar for Elvis Presley, but I've been trying to say it with a straight face, but I can't do it, brothers and sisters. But that's what I was going to tell you guys. If you want to meet somebody that actually played a backup guitar for Elvis Presley back in the days, that's Brother Sid. So it's an opportunity to meet somebody like that also. Maybe that would attract more people. But anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. And I look forward to seeing the brothers and sisters in the greater Charlotte area. If you can make it, please do. And there's a brother that's coming from Raleigh. And I told him, hey, you know, I had a meeting. The first meeting I had was down on the way to Raleigh, the west east side of Greensboro. On the way to the Raleigh, which is more in the central or eastern part of North Carolina. And he wants to be baptized, so praise the Lord for that. We're going to set that up. Anybody else in the Raleigh area, please contact me. We can start a fellowship there. And that's the original purpose of the meetings, brothers and sisters, that we would have, is not only for people to be water baptized and prayed for to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. If you're in the areas where I'm going, this is the things we'll be doing. Praying for healings, to, you know, get a word from the Lord, word of wisdom, words of knowledge, and all these kind of things. You know, a prophetic word from the Lord about what the Lord wants you to do and all this. This is things that are important to people that are Christians. But also my intention in my heart from the Lord is to each area would start a fellowship. Because, you know, most of the people that are watching my videos, you know, lots of them, they don't have a local church. There are no local churches around them that are any good. So this is a way to start like a cell group. We talked about before. You know, and there's right now, you know, people that need to be prayed for and all that. We have, you know, I know through the ministry, I know brothers and sisters in lots of places in the United States and even in other countries who could pray with you if you have a need. And I want to mention that here now. If you are living somewhere and you need to be prayed for healing or something like that, and you email me, my email is under every video I make. If you hit the See More button and it'll open up, neartochrist@aol.com. You can email me, and then if there's someone, like in Dallas, if someone messaged me from Dallas and said, hey, I'm in Dallas and I want to be water baptized, there's lots of mature, you know, elders in the church, brothers and sisters in Christ in the Dallas area. Be glad to have one of them as, you know, that are really elders in the church who could baptize you, things like that. Visit you and pray for you to be healed, whatever's your situation. And that's, we have to use the internet to our advantage, brothers and sisters. We need to use everything we have, all the resources that we have, that God has given us to become all things to all people, that we might win some to Christ. So we need, you know, to do all we can for the Lord. So brothers and sisters, and I've mentioned this all the time, I need to do a prayer to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. But Jesus told the disciples, you know, tarry at Jerusalem, Acts chapter 1, until you receive power from on high when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, that you might be a witness for me in, you know, Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the othermost parts of the world. So the Lord wants us to be a witness. We're supposed to win people to Christ. As the Lord said in the last chapter of Mark, he said that these signs shall follow those that believe in my name. They'll cast out devils. They'll lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. They'll speak with new tongues. So these are the things that the Lord wants us to do, brothers and sisters, to be an effective witness for him. Now that's what my ministry is all about, to help equip you, to release you, to, you know, get you back on track where you need to be if you're off track, to get you on track if you've never been on track, get saved, get sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, and ready to go forward and do God's will. Brothers and sisters, the time is short, as we know that. We discuss it all the time, but I say this all the time, and that's probably why I don't have 100,000 viewers like other people that are always talking about the news all the time. Listen, brothers and sisters, the whole purpose of all that stuff is not to have our ears tickled and say, oh, we're going to be raptured tomorrow, but that we would say, hey, the hour's late, the summer is gone, you know, the day is far spent, and we are not saved, as Jeremiah said, by the Spirit of God. You know, people need to get saved, and God uses his people to do his will. And that's the whole point. Everyone wants to hear, oh, a word from God. Everyone wants to hear about, you know, when's the rapture going to be and all that. But nobody wants to hear, hey, God wants you to get off of your blessed assurance and go out, be filled with the Spirit, to be sanctified, to walk in holiness, and go out and be salt and light, to be an example, to do His will, to evangelize people, to lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover, to speak with new tongues, all these things, prophecy, words of wisdom, words of knowledge, you know, all the gifts of healing, all those things, the gifts, 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Nobody wants to do that. Very few. I'll take that back. Very few. Even as Paul said, the love of many has waxed cold, or the Lord Jesus Christ said. The love of many would wax cold and grow cold in the last days. And that's what we've got, brothers and sisters. As the Lord said in Matthew chapter 24. There we are, brothers and sisters. Very few who want to go out. So that's why, you know, it's not a popular thing, brothers and sisters. Let me mention this as I'm still going with this. I'm going to keep going with this. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'll turn that down. And I mentioned this before. Do you know, when I've done crusades and I've done pastors' conferences in the Philippines and church leader conferences, and they'll be like, I've done some with 1,000 pastors and church workers, or more than that, sometimes maybe 2,000, but lots and lots of people. And I would teach just the little bit I just said and just talk about God using you and bringing revival and winning that last souls into the kingdom so we can be harvested out of here. I've been preaching the same thing since I started for 15 years now. Let's win those last souls at the times the Gentiles will be full. Jesus said this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world and every, you know, to every people, and then the end shall come. You know, we need in the fullness of the Gentiles. Jesus said, you know, to the fullness of the Gentiles. So the last Gentile to be saved, the fulfillment of the church age. There's a number. God knows when that number is filled, then it'll be the end of the church age. It'll be the rapture. Then will be the tribulation period in the time of Jacob's trouble, when God will turn, which He's already doing, but completely, and deal with Israel, with 144,000 witnesses, and then the two witnesses and the nation of Israel. And I would give that clarion call, you know, who wants to be, I would say, those of you who've been watching my videos, you've heard me say it before. Who wants to be used by God? Who wants God to use them? Who wants to be filled with the Holy Spirit? Who wants to be used by God in the gift of healing? Or, you know, signs and wonders. Who wants to be used by God in the gift of prophecy, words of wisdom, words of knowledge? Who wants to be used by God to bring in the last Gentiles? Come down here to the altar now. And I've done that in front of 100 groups. You know, lots and lots of people, at least 100 or 200 or 300 people. And, you know, minimum group probably is 100 people that I spoke to about, you know, church workers and pastors. And brothers and sisters, I can count on my two hands the number of people came down and said, I want to be used by God. And all the meetings I've done, total, not in each meeting, I get like one person per meeting, if that many, not even that, a lot of meetings, no people. People come down and say, oh, Brother Patrick, or Pastor Patrick, okay. You know, Pastor Patrick, can you pray for me because I don't have any money? I can't do anything without money. Another person comes down and says, can you pray for me? You know, I can't do anything because, you know, my back hurts. So see, the Bible says to bring every vain imagination into captivity to the Word of God. So when, see, that's why people don't want to hear the truth. They want their ears tickled. That's why they listen to all this nonsense and hype and over-exaggeration of news stories and all this kind of stuff on the internet, that, you know, and Joel Osteen and all these kind of things. They don't want to hear the truth. So we have to renew our mind with the Word of God. We renew our spirit with the Holy Spirit through prayer and worship and fasting and all these kind of things, and praying in the Spirit. That's speaking in tongues, not the gift of tongues, but speaking in tongues, praying in the Spirit between ourselves and God, to edify ourselves between ourselves and God. Building up our most holy faith, praying in spirit. And anyhow, 1 Corinthians chapter 14 also, and Jude. Anyway, brothers and sisters, so the truth of these things, as an example, somebody comes down and says, well, and it ends up being the truth, I'm telling you. Someone comes down and says, well, you know, I have to have money. For one thing, you don't have to have money to give the gospel, number one. But on the other hand, God promised us in His Word, in the Old Testament and the New Testament, Malachi 3:10. God says, put me to the test. Try me. Try me. God challenges us one time to try Him. Put Him to the test, God says. You know, bring your tithes and offerings into the storehouse and see if I won't open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing that you cannot contain. And I'll rebuke the devourer. You know, the Lord will rebuke the devourer for us. Stop the enemy from attacking us. That's a promise from God. Malachi 3:10. Now, lots of people who talk bad about, talking about the prosperity gospel, even though there is people who are off balance in that, we know that. They always use these ideas to justify the fact that they don't give, that they don't give anything to God. They don't give their love. They don't give their time. They don't give their finances. They don't give their heart. They don't give anything to God. They just want to get, receive, receive, receive. See, this kind of message, see, when you start talking about that. Oh, people, what? People want to what? They don't want to hear truth. This is truth. This is God's truth. This is the word of God. So when someone comes to me and says, I'm having financial troubles. Well, do you tithe? Do you give? Jesus said. I guess Jesus was in the prosperity gospel because he said you'll reap 30, 60, 100 fold. Jesus said, give and it'll be given unto you in good measure and pressed down, shaken together and running over, will men give into your bosom. Because with the same measure you measure with, it'll be measured back to you. Luke chapter 7. So when we give, it'll be given unto us. Whatever we sow, we reap. That's biblical doctrine. So you have to renew your mind with the fact that if you're having financial problems, you need to give. People say, I can't give because I got financial trouble. No. With God, it's the opposite. The natural, what man does is, I don't have any extra money, so I can't give. But God says, give what you have. Just like the two loaves and the fishes. This is a whole other sermon I could talk about. Give what you got, and God will multiply it. You can't outgive God. Number one, someone comes up and says, I can't serve God because I don't have any good, I'm not a good speaker. I'm shy. Well, my Bible says, Jesus said that you shall receive power from on high. Dynamite power, dunamis is the Greek word. You shall receive power from on high when the Holy Ghost has come upon you to be a witness from me in all of the world. So when you say, I don't have any power, that's what you're saying. I can't do it because I'm not a good speaker. Moses said the same thing. Moses told God, I'm slow of speech. And, they say Moses stuttered. And it says the anger kindled within God. God got angry when Moses kept saying, I'm not a good talker. And God said, who gave man his lips? Who gave man the ability to speak? In other words, all these things come from God. God is the one, and that's why he tells us in the New Testament, I'll give you a voice. Jesus said, don't think about what you're going to say in advance. I'll tell you what to say. I'll lead you by my spirit. No one will be able to gainsay against you. That's why all these churches where the preacher's got his notes and all this. When I was down at the coast of South Carolina, brothers and sisters, I ran into this. I went down there to they have a little pool there. I went down there and was going to see about doing a little evangelism. At nighttime, I went down there and there's a whole group of people that are a lot of retirees, and they stay at this same place every year at the same time, this time of year. I'd never been there, so they had a whole group of guys that were all retirees and their wives and their grandkids and all this, a whole crowd of people. And I began to talking to them, and they were talking on and on about politics. And finally, one of them asked me, what do you do? And I told them, I'm a missionary in the Philippines. I'm a pastor. I'm a preacher. And I told them about YouTube and Joshua's ministry and all that. So we started talking about God. Talking about the Lord and serving the Lord and doing God's will in our lives. And the one man. Anyway, I had a little interruption there. I'm back. So the one man I was talking to, he's a Southern Baptist, and he was telling me all about the different... from South Carolina, and he was telling me all about the great preachers in their denomination. He said, hey, we've got one evangelist that comes down here, and he doesn't even use notes that you can see. He's got his notes pasted into his Bible, so people think he's preaching without notes, and that is just awesome. I told him that was awesome, because all the preachers I see, they always have their, their typed out notes and stuff and all these things. Brothers and sisters, I know that's formal religion, and that's what people are used to, but when I read my Bible... People met in houses. When I read my Bible, it says that in 1 Corinthians chapter 12 through 14, it says, let people, let them prophesy, but no more than two or three. And then let someone interpret. All these things about the gifts of the Spirit and how they're supposed to operate. But Brothers and sisters, when you go to a traditional, when I say traditional, not biblical traditional, modern day traditional church, you know, you see people like a one-man show. You see the, you know, they sing a few songs, and then they have the offering, and then they have the, you know, something like that, and then they have the announcements, and then the preacher comes up there and preaches from his notes. A one-man show. No one's really participating. They have a choir and all that. No opportunity for the gifts of the Spirit to flow. You know that brothers and sisters, I've visited hundreds of churches, and I always talk to the pastor and the elders, and I tell them, you know what? You know, not to radicalize their format, but I tell them, you know what? Why don't you move the announcements to the beginning of the service? And why don't you move the offering to the end of the service? You know, and go straight from praise. You should have praise, then worship, and then straight into the Word. So that the Spirit, you know, the Spirit of God is flowing. The pastor can flow in the Spirit that's coming from the praise and worship, because the Bible says the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of His preaching, of His people. But you know what, brothers and sisters, of course, people are, 90% of the people are religious. They're copying traditions they learned from man, not from God. That's what I'm trying to talk about. Stop worrying about traditions of men. Knowing God is not religion, of dead religion and traditions. Some people told me, you know, I know some people that are Catholics. Oh, well, you know, our church has been around for 2,000 years, which it's not. Actually, the modern-day Catholic Church really formed after Constantine and really became Antichrist really in about 600 or so A.D., and it's been all downhill ever since, moving further in traditions and further away from the Word of God and from truth. But the point is that it doesn't matter if something is up 10,000 years old. That's just more traditions and man-made ideas and man-made doctrines. Because what did the Lord say? He quoted to us, the Lord said, repeating Himself from the Old Testament. What did Jesus say as He's saying from the burning bush? What did the Lord say? Same thing He told those Sadducees when they came to Him and said, well, you know, it says they tried to trick Jesus. And they said, well, you know, there was a man who married a woman and they had no kids. And so under the law of Moses, his brother married the woman, and there were seven of them. They all married this woman, and she had no children with none of those men. So when she dies, and, you know, when they get to heaven, whose wife shall she be? Because, see, the Sadducees are sad, you see, because they don't believe in the resurrection. So they were trying to trick Jesus. And a lot of people will focus what Jesus said. Well, people in heaven aren't married or given in marriage because they're like the angels. See, people love to focus on that part. But what did Jesus say? The first part. He said, you are in error in your understanding of the Bible, because God said, what did God say to Moses? He didn't say, I was. He said, I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And Jesus was referring to the fact that Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob are still alive in heaven. But it's also that God is, I am, not I was, or I'm going to be. I am. God is in the now, right now, in this moment with us, brothers and sisters. He's the great I am, not the great I was. Religion is saying I'm the great I was. People that are overly obsessed with getting to heaven, they're saying that He's the I'm going to be. But what I'm trying to tell you, He is the great I am, the great right now. God is here right now, right with us. He's all-knowing, omniscient, in all places, omnipresent, and all-powerful, omnipotent. God is everywhere. God is all-knowing, and God is all-powerful. And I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, the Bible says. He is the great I am, not the great I was. So get off the religion and all the religious ideas. God is here with us now. Stop worrying about what happened yesterday and stop thinking about what's going to happen tomorrow. And that is the key to walking in the power of God, to get your mind right that God is with us today. God wants to use you today. As Jesus said, and I'm quoting Jesus when I'm talking about this on the Sermon on the Mount, Matthew chapter 5, 6, and 7. He said, don't give any thought for tomorrow. Don't give any thought of the past. Think on what's going on right now, today. You know, the evil in this day is sufficient for you to think about. Matthew chapter 6, He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these earthly things you desire will be added unto you. So set your affection on things above, not on things of this earth, on our Lord and our Savior. He's with us. He'll never leave us nor forsake us. Renew your mind with these truths of God. Stop worrying about what's going on in this world and start worrying about what God's called you to do in the midst of the storm. Does God want you to walk on the water, or does he want you to stay in the boat and cower? Ooh, it's a ghost. At least Peter had enough sense to say, Lord, if that's you, bid me to come unto you. And Jesus said, come on. And he stepped out on the water. Praise God. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Right now he is with us. Right now. That's why you have no power of God. That's why you have a form of godliness but deny the power thereof. That's why you have no power of God in yourself and no power of God in your church. Many of you, not all of you, of course. I'm not talking to you. Hey. Because you're not seeing the truth, the reality that God is the great I am. He is with us right now. Never leave us nor forsake us. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. My God will provide all of my needs according to his riches in glory. Hallelujah. Praise God. God provides all things that we need to run the race. That's why so many people, they ask me, Brother Patrick, I want to be baptized in the Holy Spirit. But why? Why do you want to be baptized in the Holy Spirit? Many people are dead sea Christians. You know, the river of God flows in like the Jordan. It flows into the Dead Sea, but nothing flows out. But God wants us to be like that Sea of Galilee. See, the River Jordan flows into it and then back out the bottom of it. It's a living water. It's a living. The river flows through it. God anoints us. As he said, the Lord said, you shall receive power on high. For what? To have a good time? To be drunk in the Spirit? To be clowning around? No. That you might be a witness for me. Offer yourself, as Paul said, Romans chapter 12, offer yourself as a living sacrifice. Empty yourself of this world. Empty yourself of dead religion. Empty yourself of false doctrines and lies and deceit of this world. And be ye filled with the Holy Ghost. May the Spirit of God overtake you right now in the name of Jesus. I ask you to come in agreement with me right now. You want to be baptized, Holy Spirit? O ye of little faith? Jesus said, if you have the faith as a grain of mustard seed, and say to this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, and not doubt in your heart, but believe those things you say shall come to pass. You shall have whatever you saith. Mark 11, 22, 23, and 24. Have faith in God. Pray right now with me to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And pray that God will fill you, that he might use you to be a witness for him. Hallelujah. God blesses us that we might be a blessing. God told Abraham, I bless you that you might be a blessing. That's why we need money. That's why all of the things that we need, power of the Holy Spirit, the gifts of the Holy Spirit, finances, a mouth to speak, you know, a car, whatever we need. We need those things to go and do what God called us to do. We need those things. God shall provide all of your needs according to his riches in glory. Hallelujah. In Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:19. Pray in agreement with me right now. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, Lord, we come in agreement right now that all those within the sound of my voice, under the sound of the trumpet call of God, hallelujah, shall receive power from on high that the Holy Ghost has come upon them. Hallelujah, that they may be witnesses unto you in this place, in their town, in their home, and into the uttermost parts of this world. Right now I speak it, and we come in agreement right now to receive the Holy Spirit right now in the name of Jesus Christ, to be baptized in the Holy Spirit with evidence of speaking in tongues. Now I speak it right now. By faith we receive it in the name of Jesus right now. I ask you right now to come in agreement with me, brothers and sisters. Come in agreement with me. What I'm going to do, I'm going to do it right now. So, you know, there's dozens and dozens of people who have contacted me and received the baptism of the Holy Spirit when I made videos before, over the time that I've been on YouTube. Now I'm going to pray right now in just a minute, and I'm going to ask you to come in agreement with me. Right now we're going to count to three. We're going to begin to praise and worship the Lord. That just that you would, Jesus, in Acts chapter 2, it says that they began to speak in tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. It's a river of living water John chapter 7, out of your belly will flow rivers of living water. Salvation, John 4, wellspring of water, of living water. Baptism of the Holy Spirit, river of living water flowing out of your belly, John chapter 7. Now I want you to pray in agreement with me right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Here we go. And then when I'm going to count to three, we're going to praise and worship to God. At the count of three, you'll begin to speak in other tongues, an unknown tongue to you, to the speaker, in the name of Jesus. All right? I'm going to pray with you right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's worship the Lord. Bless your holy name, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Halabasubai. Kidaramasubai. Hallelujah. I decree and declare that you would receive it right now. The baptism of the Holy Spirit. Receive it. For God has already gave it on Pentecost. Receive it. Receive it right now. But keep worshiping and praising the Lord. Praise the Lord right now. I speak right now on the count of three. You would receive it by faith. One, two, three. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Halalabasukinayama. Asumai. Kiaramasubai. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord is with thee. Hallelujah. The Lord is with thee. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's the sword of the Spirit. Hallelujah. The Lord's sword. His word be in your mouth right now in the name of Jesus. That's an interpretation of what I said. That the sword of the Spirit of God would be in your mouth. His word, even the word of God, would flow from your mouth right now in the name of Jesus. Now I want to tell you something. That you worship the Lord, thank the Lord, and praise the Lord for filling you with His Holy Spirit. Get in the Word, particularly the New Testament. Don't read the Old Testament and try to read yourself in there or try to translate and interpret fulfillment of Old Testament prophecies, but read the New Testament. Read the book of Acts. Read the Gospels. Read the epistles and see what God would have His church do, hallelujah, in this day. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will be glad and rejoice in it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Don't get your preaching from truck drivers and don't get your news from preachers. But get your word from the word of God and from those who are preachers who are preaching the word of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Be ye redeemed from the things of this world. Be redeemed from sin. Be redeemed from doubt and unbelief. Be redeemed from smoking. Be redeemed from drinking. Be redeemed from drugs, be redeemed from pornography, be redeemed from laziness, slothfulness, too much television. Be redeemed from these things of the world, that the Lord might set His grace upon you, set His love upon you, set His affections upon you, that you might go forward and do His will. Hallelujah. May the kingdom of God be birthed in you this day. Hallelujah. That you might be ready, willing, able, and ready for when your King calleth, that you would listen and hear and obey immediately when the King calls your name. Hallelujah. For He has a calling, a high calling, that we have in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith to the church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. May you hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to the church. Hallelujah. For the Lord is about to come for His bride. Time is short. The days are running short. You must be redeem the time that you have lost in this world. We know the Lord's coming. Stop obsessing about what's going on in this natural world, in this devil's kingdom, and start obsessing on the race that God called you to run individually, and get to it. Get to it. Be prepared against the third day for the holy calling of God to come up here. Be prepared against the third day. God is coming for a people without spot or blemish. He said in His word, He's coming for that bride without spot or blemish. Be ready. Be ready against the third day. That's the thus says the Lord. Hallelujah. Be ready against the third day. For the Lord is coming at a time, a date, an hour when you think not, Jesus said. Be ready for the Master's call. Be ready to hear the Master's voice. See, lots of you have to don't have an ear to hear. That's why Jesus said, he who have an ear, let him hear. Get your ear to hear, spiritual ear. There's so many people, well, I got ears. That's the whole point. You can't even understand the sentence, he who has an ear, let him hear, what the Spirit said to the church. You can't understand it. That's a spiritual ear. It's not the natural ear. If it was a natural ear, then the Lord wouldn't need to say that. step into the water. I'm just speaking as the Lord is leading me. Get in, step into the water. Go down a little bit deeper. Get into the water of the river of the living God. Step out into water and the river of the living God. Hallelujah. For he is there. He is there. He is the river. The Holy Spirit is that river. Get out in the river. And I've said this before, and the Lord is leading me to say it again. Go out deeper. Stop. You know, when you're standing in a river and you're wading out there, your feet are on the ground. Go on out there. Go on out there where the water's over your head. Go on out there where you can't touch the bottom anymore. You know, leave your floaties on the shore and get on a little bit deeper. Get on out there. Get on out there in the water. Get on out there in the water. Go on a little bit deeper. Hallelujah. Go on a little bit deeper out in the water. Hallelujah. Let the Lord carry you off where he wants to take you by the river of his living water. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. I want to cut this off. I had to split this video, so I'll combine it. So you'll see there's a gap there at about 18 minutes. God bless you guys.